Welcome and thank you for your interest in our online practice tests. This video will familiarize you to the online test environment. So let's jump straight in.
To access the online tests, please navigate to http://caseacademy.com/lms in your browser. This will take you to the home page of the testing environment. What you are seeing here is the home page. It lists all the tests available at our site. To access the test that you have enrolled for, you will need to log in. To log in, just click on the login link in the right hand top corner. This is the site login page. On this page, you need to enter the username and password and then click on the login button. For most users, username is a combination of their first name and last name, where all in small cases. For example, my name is Makarand Karkare, and my username will be Makarand Karkare in small case. In case you are one of the few people who have a first name and last name matching with some other person who has enrolled, then our office will contact you and give you your username. The password for everybody is common and it is set as capital KACE exclamation 234. So enter your username and password and click on the login button to access the test that you have enrolled for. This is the student dashboard. You will reach here on successful login. You will see different courses that you have registered for. We have created a special course called Online Test Familiarization to give you a test drive of giving a test. You can access tests inside a course by clicking on the course name. We will now enter the Online Test Familiarization course by clicking on the Online Test Familiarization link. This is the course homepage. You can see all the tests released in this course. In this course, we have released only one test. We enter the test by clicking on the link. This is the starting page for the test. It provides all the information about the test. For example, in this case, it shows that only one attempt is allowed and the time limit for the test is 10 minutes. All the tests in the test series will have only one attempt. However, the time for individual test will depend on number of questions available in the test. You will now get another confirmation dialog. You can still cancel out of the test if you have any doubts. However, if you are sure that the test can start now, click on the start attempt button to start that. You will now be taken to the first question of the test. As you can see, the screen has three main zones. One zone, the zone in blue, will contain the question and various options. To answer a question, you will just need to click on any of the options that you think is correct. The leftmost zone, the quiz navigation zone, contains numbered links to different questions, and you can directly jump to any particular question by clicking on the corresponding number. The middle zone here gives you the status of the question. For example, it says that this question is not yet answered, it has only one mark, and if I want, I can flag the question. We will see what does it mean to flag the question later. Once you have answered a question, you can click on the next button and go to the next question. Notice here that the answered question, the question one, has become gray, whereas all the other unanswered questions remain white in background. You can go to any question by clicking on those numbers. If a particular question is difficult, you can click on the flag question in the center and it will mark the question as flagged. Notice that question 3 has been flagged. The flag the question link has now become remove flag. It shows a red flag. Also, the link for the question starts showing a corner, red corner. This tells us that a particular question is flagged. The use of this is at the end we can quickly identify what questions we wanted to correct and move back to flagged questions. Notice that I am on the last question now. All the questions except this question and question 3 have been answered. I can click on the next button after answering this question and I would be taken to the finish attempt screen. This screen is the summary of my attempt. It shows me, for example, that I haven't yet answered question number 3. And so I can select to go back to question number 3 and answer it again. As you can see, I have gone back to question number 3 and I have answered it. Now to finish the question, I don't need to keep doing next through all the questions. I can directly click on this link called Finish Attempt and it will take me directly to my attempt summary screen. At the bottom of the attempt summary screen, there is the Submit All and Finish button. I need to click this button to actually submit the test. If I exceed my time, the test will be finished and submitted automatically. As soon as I finish the test, I would get to know my results immediately. This is the screen I will get as soon as I finish the test. As you can see here, the links to the questions in the quiz navigation block have now become color-coded. They are pink where I have answered the questions wrongly. They are green where my questions have been answered correctly. In case I had not answered any question, those links will remain white in background. I can now go to every question and look at what went wrong or what went right. Also, in this block here, it shows me the summary of my attempt. It shows me how much time I took, how many things I got correct, and how many things I got right. Below every question, either wrongly answered or rightly, there will be additional information provided. This, in case of maths, will typically contain solutions in case of difficult problems and things like that. This adds more value because not only does it tell you that it is wrong, but it will also tell you what is wrong. We will provide information about what went wrong or what is correct in case of difficult questions. For most questions which are not difficult, there may not be any additional explanation given. You can come back to the test at a later date by logging into the system, going to the dashboard, going to the course, and clicking on the test. If you have already given the test, you will get a screen like this. This screen, for example, tells me that I submitted this test on 5th July and I had got a grade of 5 out of 10. I can click on the review button here, and this review button will take me to the same screen that I saw at the end of my attempt. As I told earlier, we have set the same password for everybody. But whenever you want, you can change your password. To change the password, click on the down arrow key next to your name in the right-hand top corner. You will get a drop-down menu. From the drop-down menu, click on the preferences, which is currently highlighted. This will take you to the preferences screen. On the preferences screen, click on the change password link. You will now be on the change password screen. On this screen, you will have to first enter your current password and enter a new password twice. At the bottom, there is a save changes button. Click on the save changes button to save your new password. Please remember the rule that you must follow to set a password. It must be at least 8 characters. There must be at least one digit, at least one lowercase letter, and at least one uppercase letter, and at least one non-alphanumeric character. Your password must satisfy this rule. This brings us to the end of this small video. Hope it helped you get familiarized with our test environment. Please contact us if you have any difficulties. Thank you.